be my honor to show you the ready charges for the wormhole. The choice is yours. This is a high honor, Arisen. See, you do not take it lightly. Here are the details. Wondrous tidings, Arisen. The Duke is to grant you an audience. His Grace wishes to commend you for your valor and your service to the land. Know, however, that any errand you have taken on will be left to another to complete. You will also be asked to return your writ of permission to join the hunt. If you have aught left undone, pray tend to it afore you come to see the Duke, sir. I must be clear. Your audience with His Grace will put an end to any current tasks, and you will be asked to return your license to the worm hunt. Knowing that, are you prepared to see His Grace now? I see. Then go, and tend to what business keeps you, sir. I will await you here.
We can rest till day or night. Simply leave word with the innkeep.
'Tis of a scale fit to dwarf Cassidy's.
I'm trying to...
The capital is home to a pawn guild where my kind gathers.
Represents the bond between Pawn and Arisen. Do take full advantage.
A grand cathedral fit for a grand city.
It is quite the intricate maze of passages. I fear I'll soon be lost.
The choice is yours. This is a wonder. No, if you. Knowing that, you are quite certain. No tasks left incomplete. No need for the license to the hunt. Understood. Then pray. Enter the castle, sir. A guide awaits within to see you to His Grace.
To accompany you to the Duke.
Thank you. 'Tis hard to find reason to go on.
Please, sir, I have a job to do. He'll go no further.
The noblest of convictions can't fill a man's belly as well as the basest coin, eh?
Thank you. Tonight the Fisher Knight leaves the humble shores of home for the heady depths of Cart. Pray, let this token from humble Festy garner favor with the Leviathans within. Oh, tut, no time for thanks, friend. The Duke awaits. Sail on, dear knight. Sail on.
Look at the grave, knight.
Word of your feats has reached us here, sir. You've the worm's own strength to cleft the Hydra's pate in one blow. No doubt you'll prove more than equal to the dragon. I await tell of your next victory.
Pray, do not play a greater fool than I, sir. I do not welcome the competition. The Duke awaits.
I am called Mirabelle, sir. Lady-in-waiting to my mistress, Eleanor, newly come to this place as His Grace's bride. A duchess now she is. It is a pleasure to make your acquaintance, Arisen.
No further, sir. We're not to admit any guests past this point.
I cannot fathom His Grace's waste of coin on such festivity, while our defenses stand bare. Just the same, I'll not refuse his wine.
Longevity can seem a curse when it means living to see such times.
I'll grant such gaiety may unite the men and stoke them to greater valor. But do we truly have the time to lend such pursuits with a dragon upon us?
If Duke Edmund judges morale that important, I'll attempt to enjoy myself.
I fear your crown outshines my own. By my command, every road in Brancis shall be open to you henceforth as a member of the Worm Hunt. May your efforts help deliver us from the shadow of the dragon. As long as that damnable beast draws breath, I'll fain accept any help on offer.
Danger stalks the capital even now. Are the rest of you truly blind to that simple truth?
Let us speak another time, sir.
The sovereign of this land ill comprehends the urgency of the danger it faces. This eve's empty pomp is ample proof. All gaiety, without a hint of real concern. I'll allow, 'tis well understandable. A people numbed by two generations of peace cannot be expected to know true resolve. 'Tis a lesson taught by fire and sacrifice. Pray, let His Grace learn before the fire takes all. But I ought not speak in such bold terms before His Grace.
All through my reign, I foresaw the coming of this danger.
And so I gathered men into armies, stones into strongholds. I readied for war, and then you were risen. You came to us, and the dragon with you. Pray, think on the meaning of that, and of your duty.
Even as his guest, I'll thank you to keep your distance from his grace.
You stand before the Duke. Pray, remember your place.
No business with the Duchess. I'll ask you to go no further, sir.
Arisen, I would speak with you.
Private.
This is not the place. 'Tis a conversation best had after dark. Meet me in the courtyard by night.
Duke has seemed different of late.
So this is the Arisen. I see no difference in your mien than any other knight. What is it you possess that sets you so apart? A hidden strength? Good fortune?
Arisen, hail, sir. It seems you truly stand apart from the rest of us. Some sneered when I presented the Hydra's head, said it was your feet alone that won it. In truth, I cannot deny it. I had no hand in it. 'Tis plain fact. But what of the enlistment corps, then? What meaning does our fealty hold? I have no answer to give my men. to give myself. I leave me. I fear I will be well drunk by Eve's end.
I've naught else to say.
Carry on in your endeavors for the Duchy, Arisen. As long as you've the will to fight, I shall see you are granted the opportunity.
Ah, the glorious return of the inimitable, the indomitable, the unforgettable! Scratch that last one. Who were you again? I jest, Fisher Knight, for I am a jester. I dare say every man in Grand Sorin knows who you are by now. Your fame is little wonder at the fearsome rate you've solved the Duchy's woes. The Arisen nods, they say, and lo, the spears do shake!
My, my. Apologies, dear warrior. But to see a face austere as the castle walls adorned with this... Still, 'tis more agreeable than the endlessly dour air of most of my husband's sawn swords. Valor dwells in the heart, after all. The brave ought not need their raiment to speak for their mettle, no?
Hail, dear warrior of the lovely helm. I fear I am remiss in asking your name, sir. Arisen? You must forgive me. I fear I am grossly ignorant in matters of war. I had thought all who fought shared the title warrior. But again, you must excuse me. I am Eleanor, come just a few days past as a bride to the Duke. I pray you will serve my lord husband faithfully, Sir Warrior. I presume the crown you bear is a mark of your station as the Arisen? I must apologize for my laughter, good sir. I assure you I meant no disrespect. You would gift me your crown, dear warrior? You are far too kind. I shall cherish it. I shall pray for your safe travels, sir. Until we meet again, dear Arisen. I shall pray for your safe travels, sir. Until we meet again.
By decree of the Duke, you are to be allowed free passage into the castle. This right extends only to your person, and you are advised to comport yourself fittingly. A grievous breach in conduct will see you removed from the castle, or worse. You will take your orders from the Duke's Chamberlain, Aldous. Speak to him for further instruction. May the Maker see you on to further glory, sir.
How fared your audience with His Grace, Arisen? Aldous Ludric Sorn at your service, sir. I serve as a chamberlain in the Duke's court. As you may have seen for yourself, it seems His Grace is unwell. In truth, there is worry enough to make any man's head ache, but I fear he ails of worse than worry. Perhaps I ought not speak further on the matter, for my own well-being. I am charged with assigning royal orders, tasks of great import issued by the Duke himself. pray forgive the bother, but I ask that you come to see me here in the castle whenever circumstances allow you to take on assignment. The future of this war is murky, sir. May your efforts help to bring its end into sight.
This worry is murder on my back.
You've made quite the name for yourself since last we spoke. I fear I must apologize again, sir. On the matter of the slain Hydra, there is talk on the street that it was I felled the beast. Mistake me not. I told His Grace true that it was your doing alone. It seems my name was added as a matter of political expedience. I've no love of politics. Lies by another name. And in these dark times, what's more? Who can spare the effort to keep up the dance with the dragon come? I've no love of politics. And in these...
What matter could demand such secrecy? Representatives from lands sworn to aid against the dragon will be gathered in the audience chamber. Representatives from lands sworn to aid against the dragon will be gathered in the audience chamber.
Representatives from lands sworn to aid against the dragon will be gathered in the audience chamber.
It pains me to burden you, busy as you are, with the royal orders, but there is aught I would speak of with you. 'Tis a cause of worry, though I speak only for myself and not as chamberlain. Might I beg a moment? Skeletons have been sighted near the capital these past few days. Elsewhere, I've had no end of reports of secret meetings among the zealots of salvation. I cannot help but see the two as intertwined, though I have no evidence to prove it. Still, I'll be damned if I allow their kind to go corrupting the minds of good people for want of evidence. Arisen, I ask this as a favor. Will you look into these events and hunt out any thread that connects them? I believe I've learned where the cult meets. I've made note of it on your map. I ask you begin your search there. Go and learn what you can. I've detailed our nearest estimate of their meeting place upon your map. Above all, see that you are not discovered in your search. Quiet as a shadow.
Those woods.
And what of the pending contest between Arisen and Dragon? We wait, and we listen for further word. Hear ye, His Grace, Duke Edmund!
Hear now, a warrior such as yourself seeks always. If you aid me in a small matter, you shall have access to weapons both fearsome and powerful. What do you say? Excellent. So, have you heard tell of the master weaponsmith in these parts? His talent is without measure, but he's stubborn as a plough beast and sells only to a chosen circle of clients. To such patrons, he gifts an idol to make his favor known. I must gain such an icon and access to his wares, no matter what the cost. It's often said you possess a talent for discovery. Secure me a figurine, and I shall provide weapons the likes of which you have never dreamed. What say you? Will you help? The master works all, you can't go wrong. Come again.
Does the Arisen's mind know no bounds? Do we witness a rock? For this land's next great hero!
The dragon's own tongue.
That Hexer's lived there for many a year. Even as a child, I heard cradle tales of her witchery.
His Grace is keen to seek out the old crone. Even now, he gathers men for a search party.
I wonder if there are rarities from abroad. This must be where salvation meets.
How's a day find you?
The realm's in a right state, eh?
You've spoken to Bodrick? Or heard him, more like. The way he talks, all in verse like that. Some days I take him for a prophet.
Duke Edmund was an Arisen in his day, attended by pawns of his own. What has become of them, I wonder?
Seems queer to hold a secret meeting in daylight.
Hello. Can I help you? Can I help you? Then I bid.
I see you're hard at work on an errand, friend. Truly, even in these times, as long as man you, that makes spoken the truth. Tis work, well.
Patrons all post work notices in the alehouse. Many's the person comes to drink here, all bearing different tales.
Of a scale fit to dwarf Cassilis.
An Arisen, were you? I hear tell you met with the Duke himself.
What use is chasing after coin?
I care not if you are the Arisen. I've no time for idle talk.
Hello. Can I help you, then?
Seems that fortune smiles on those that aren't me.
I've heard the talk, love. You're the Duke's new favorite, eh? Oh, I'm envious. I'll bet you've not missed a meal in recent memory. Though I suppose that's a privilege bought by placing yourself in harm's way, eh?
Hello. Can I help you? Can I help you? Then I...
Hello. Can I help you? Can I help you? Then I'd be...
Hail, Arisen. Looking dour as ever, I see. I've a proposal that might put some cheer in those cheeks. Will you hear me? Well, it's like this. A peddler is only as good as her suppliers. For my own part, being both clever and beautiful, I've little trouble keeping an inventory. But contentment leads to failure, so I seek new weaponsmiths to supply my shop. I have a certain one in mind, a man of singular talent, but caustic temperament. Much as you, in truth. The smith refuses audience with all but select clients. And upon such clients he bestows an idol, so as to prove his favor. If I can recover such a figurine, I would have singular right to peddle his wares in these parts. There is no cost I will not bear to gain this icon. So what say you, Arisen? Will you retrieve an idol for me? This is a job most suited to your talents. I pray you will not fail me in it. You'll find naught but the finest... Find naught but the finest wares. You'll find naught but... Find not. Thank you very much.
What's that?
That explains the pawns, at least.
The scrivener at the Black Cat here can duplicate objects in your possession. What's this?
That ladder will see us to the roof.
This looks interesting.
roof to roof, Arisen.
What's more, the proprietor can furnish forgeries of certain items. Precious things gone lost or missing have a way of turning up there.
Realm's in a right state, eh?
I wonder what's inside.
I'm sick of it all.
Once our preparations are complete, we ought meet with Chamberlain Aldous.
I hear no. Have your pick. What will it be today?
Aye, the inn offers a clean bed, but it deals in vocations and skills besides.
You know more of the witch? Rumors swirl of late. Most on how she speaks with the dragon. Consorts with them more, like some say. Others claim she summoned the worm herself. Whatever the case, we could do worse than seek her counsel if she knows aught of the beast. Speak with the soldiers to hear more of the witch. Even now they mount an expedition to find her. Others, whatever, speak.
Arisen springs from your hand, and thus you must make us all free. Alive, alive. Such talk of alive! It's all become rather a bore. You should, like the birds, or the beasts of the fields, take fret in such things nevermore. Do you stand before me? Do you see me true? Or is this some terrible jape? The Maker can't save you if he isn't there. No matter how you bend and you scrape. You claim that you live just by thinking it so. But such thoughts are wicked and sad. To never consider that you might be false is a path trod by only the mad. You claim that you live.
Can I live long enough for my...
Even the saltiest fishermen venture far from shore.
I'll go with Moss.
Right away.
The roads are safer than the grass. Let's stay away.
This encampment serves as a fine bulwark against monsters.
Nature is unbridled here. It is quite a pleasant corner.
The witchwood is this way, Master. Care to find out where this path leads?
There, Master! Wolves! Don't allow them to surround you! Nothing back!
Victory. Human foes may fight as fiercely as any monster if pressed. Armed bandits arisen.
Hold nothing back!
Struggling foe!
And left exposed after a grand strike.
I only hope we survive the next.
Our strength brought us victory.
Get them, boys!
The witchwood is this way, Master. Proceed with caution, Master. There may be more
before striking.
Oh.
bandits, Arisen. Leave it to me.
I'll go at once.
I'm on my way. They're armed, Master! There, Master! Wolves!
Come looking for a fight.
Hurry to Selene's cottage. Leave it to me.
The forest of Southern Francis are ever shrouded in this thick mist. Shallow enough to cross. How thick this forest. The wood is uncommon thick, but almost as if it means to hide out away.
There, Master! Wolves!
It is a place rich in valuable resources.
You're going searching this area now. Find an opening, then strike.
Few people are willing to take such risks, even for Luca.
Strike.
I'm on my way.
I'll go at once.
She conjures a dragon! Damnable hex!
Burn her!
She's in with the dragon! By the Maker!
The rock! It moves! Monster!
This is her devilry!
Where it goes!
security.
What's this? Could she have gone back here?
Anytime. This.
Come, Master. We must find Selene.
We must have missed something. To Selene.
And this girl, Selene, was my pawn. The soul of an Arisen cannot but affect their follower. Given time, the pawn will assume the Arisen's very form. This is the bestowal of spirit, or so I named it. I did not grasp the full meaning of this transfer when first I noticed it. But see well, Selene. See how she resembles me? I pray she can soon live her life as a human true. Age and experience separate us, Arisen, but I know you ken my words. Selene is more than born now. She yearns to choose the course of her life, free from the will of others. If you can aid in this, there may yet be a future for her.
I wonder what's inside.
I am sorry, Arisen. You share in my troubles through no fault of your own. Some part of me has long known I was, in truth, a pawn. I do not age or die as others. And always I found making my own decisions difficult. Gran gifted me a portion of her very soul. It was a kindness I can never repay. At first, I knew not how to use this gift. But now I have met you. My pawn print.
Yes, I see it now. In truth, I had not thought as much. The ways of pawns and humans are so very close.
Can I truly live? Can I be?
Shadows of life, doomed to forever echo out across the rift. But soon you will be free of this unending cycle.
would be with you.
I learned what to do in this quest.
I've gained quest knowledge.
Arisen and Pons share a rare bond.
This looks interesting.
Please, Arisen, say that I might stay in your village, under your roof. I want dearly for a place I can feel safe. Herbs? Ah, for brewing ale. Very well. Here, you are welcome to these. Please, Arisen, I will...
We're at a disadvantage fighting the marsh.
pinched!
At a disadvantage fighting in the marsh.
A golden idol.
Perhaps
what meaning do you suppose those stones hold?
Once our preparations are complete, we ought meet with Chamberlain Olders. Now, where shall we head?
The idols are said to come. Which you secure is not important, so long as it permits me to parley with the weaponsmith. I trust your skill is on measure with the task, or I would not ask it of you. The master works all, you can't go wrong. Works all, you can't come again.
This inn can serve as the hub of our journeys.
The idol, which you, I trust, the master works all. The master Nice work, Kamage.
Traveling about in this line teaches a fellow things, like how nothing stays in one place for long. My blackguard father, least of all. Now, let us talk of business. Now, pray.
I hear an audience with the Duke now. Have your pick, any you like. What will it be today? What will it be today? Have your pick, any you like. What will it be today? Have your pick. What will it be today? What will it be today? What will it be today? Have your pick. Come again.
Are complete.
Aye, the inn offers a clean bed, but it deals in vocations and skills besides.
I see you're hard at work on an errand, friend. Pray take all the time you need. Truly, even... That makes... Oh, completed the request, have you? Wonderful, wonderful. Here, friend, the wages for your efforts. A pleasure, as always.